To complement the rush of the Bears' front four, inventive head coach Jim Dooley instituted a five-man defensive backfield aimed at nullifying football's most lethal offensive weapon, the forward pass. But today, the Bears faced one of the NFL's premier quarterbacks, Sonny Jurgensen, and Sonny riddled the Bears' secondary for nearly 300 yards and four touchdowns. Jurgensen's favorite receiver in the early going was last year's leading receiver, Charlie Taylor. With it third and seven on the Bears 16, Sonny tossed a perfect strike to towering Pat Richter for a 7-0 Redskin lead. Unable to perform through most of the exhibition schedule due to a nagging arm injury, Jurgensen stilled all fears about his arm by establishing complete mastery over the Bears. The birth of a decent Washington running attack can in part be attributed to the acquisition of All-Pro guard John Wooten, number 67, who led Swift Jerry Allen to a two-touchdown margin over Chicago. Trailing 14-0, the Bears unleashed Jim Dooley's total offense concept, which in effect is simply Gale Sayers running, receiving, and in general just being marvelous. Nearing the close of the first quarter, Sayers zipped 43 yards through the Redskins before stepping out of bounds on the Washington 12. Chicago quarterback Jack Concannon, who is always more comfortable running than he is passing, accounted for Chicago's first touchdown, aided by number 72 Jim Caddiel's crushing block on Pat Fisher and some nifty running of his own. Concannon led the Bears to within one touchdown of the Redskins. In the second period, a Bear drive to tie the game was canceled when Concannon was forced to flee from the pocket, and his desperation pass was intercepted by Brig Owens on the one-foot line. Always the gambler, Jurgensen stuns the Bears by passing on first down. Behind flawless protection, he lofted a pass to set back Jerry Allen, who easily outdistanced linebacker Dick Butkus and raced a record equaling 99 yards for a score. Of the four 99-yard passes for touchdowns in NFL history, the Redskins have taken part in three of them. Behind again by 14 points, the Bears rallied as Brian Piccolo dashed 12 yards for a touchdown that narrowed the Redskin lead to 21-14. Before the season, the experts conceded that new, varied, and sophisticated defenses had caught up with the offense. Today, Sonny Jurgensen destroyed one of football's most potent defensive units, and on this Sunday, defense almost became a lost art. On two passes, one to Charlie Taylor and the other to Pat Richter, Washington had regained their two-touchdown advantage. Richter's second touchdown of the day served to accent his promotion from a seldom-used spot player to a full-time starter. Refusing to wilt under Jurgensen's constant pressure, the Bears came back on a pass to Sayers and a knifing five-yard touchdown run by number 29, Ronnie Bull, that made the score 28-21 at halftime. By the start of the second half, both teams had settled down. The scoring did not come in flurries, but it still came. On the only scoring play of the period, Jurgensen and Richter collaborated a third time for a touchdown, climaxing the finest day by the tight end in a heretofore modest five-year career. In the fourth quarter, the Bears fought back gallantly, but it was too late. Jack Concannon's ground-eating scrambling carried Chicago to their last score of the game when Ronnie Bull blasted 8 yards to his second touchdown. In a 38-28 victory, the Redskins had found out that all they missed during a lackluster preseason was the strong right arm of their quarterback, Sonny Jurgensen. In defeat, the Bears seemed to have lost something just as valuable.